Wanted to go to Africa, and we had met John and heard his story and wanted to go and see it for ourselves. And when we decided to go, Kim asked if we'd be willing to lead a team, and we said we would.
I wanted to go wherever I thought God was moving, and from all that I've heard from John Wandera and just everything, I really knew that God was moving in Uganda, and I wanted to be a part of that.
Whether I wanted to go or not wanted to go, I knew that God wanted me to go, and so I signed up.
I wanted to go to Africa to see the people and the joy, and I'd seen that they are happy and they have so much less than we have, material wise.
They're the warmest people I've ever met. They're so loving and giving and genuine and just passionate about Jesus.
They have a huge capacity for faith because of, not just in spite of, their lack of resources.
An incredible opportunity just to love on people that were in the bush and to know that we weren't that different.
They have the joy of the Lord deep down inside them, and just worship and honor and glorify Him for what they have and His great sacrifice.
But it was just so encouraging to be able to pray with people in the hospitals. Doctors weren't wanting us to do that. And all the patients were just very, you know, ecstatic about us praying for them.
They just pray expecting God to work because they don't have a whole lot else to put their faith in.
You intend to go bringing something or doing something, and as you're doing those things, you just learn more about yourself, and you learn more about your heart for God and your heart for people, so it ends up being a lot more for you.
Going on a mission trip definitely got me out of my comfort box. It got me out from under the United States flag, which I am so grateful for, but also it got me under God more. I had to depend on Him and trust Him.
I think I was set on fire in Uganda, set on fire for God, just seeing that He's moving in the world. Even if it doesn't feel like He's moving here in America, He's moving in the world.